We're on Yadayim Perek Gimel Mishnah Hey, fifth Mishnah in the third chapter of Masechet Yadayim. We've talked about, we know that books, we said Sifrei Kodesh are Mitamei Et Yadayim. Mitamei Et Yadayim, they make Yadayim Tamei. Remember, we said the reason was because people would hide there, they would keep their Sifrei Kodesh with their Truma. And therefore, the mice would get to the Truma, and then the mice would eat their Sifrei Kodesh, would eat their books. That's bad. So therefore, they said, you know what, it's all Tamei. And not only that, as we said later, they said, if you touched Sifrei Kodesh, your hands are Tamei Yadayim. And then they said, you know what? Hands are Tamei Yadayim no matter what. But this obviously raises the question of, what's a book? What constitutes a book? And then we're going to get into, this is a very famous, actually, very famous Mishnah, because it comes to the thorny question of, what is considered a holy book? What's part of the biblical canon? As we'll see, it was a huge machloket and a very famous quote of Rabbi Akiva at the end. Says the Mishnah, Sefer, let's read the Sefer Kodesh. Shenimchak, it got rubbed out. It was erased. All it had left was 85 letters. Kiparshat Vayihi bin Soa Aron. It is the length of Vayihi bin Soa Aron. You know, as we know, the Chazal said that the book of Bamidbar is really three books. It's up to Vayihi bin Soa Aron. Vayihi bin Soa Aron is like it has upside down nuns. So the upside down nuns represent a sefer in and of itself, and then the rest of Bamidbar. So that parsha of Vayihi bin Soa Aron is 85 letters long. That's all it is. That's the length of an entire sefer, as Chazal said. And therefore, if all you have in whatever book that you had, a sefer Yoshua, and all you have left of it is 85 letters, it's still a book, says the Mishnah, and therefore, mitamei et hayadayim. Just to see this point of the Bartunura, the parsha of Vayihi bin Soa Aron, chashuva kesefer bifnei atzmo. According to Chazal, it was considered in a book in and of itself. Kach amu b'midrash, it says, chatzva amudei shiva. That we said in Mishlei that Chatzva, it's established, it's Amudim, it stands seven, meaning Elu Shiv'a Sifrei Torah. You think there are five books of Moshe, Chamisha Chumshei Torah. No, there are Shiv'a Sifrei Torah, there are seven. Shesefer Vayidaber, the book of Vayidbar, Bamidbar, Nechlak Lishalosha Svarim. It's divided into three, as we've said before, up to Vayihi bin Soa, Vayihi bin Soa, and then the rest of the book. So there are how many books, if there's like trivia. According to Chazal, how many books of the Torah were there? There were not five, there were seven. Okay, and so therefore, if all you have is 85 letters left, Shmonim b'chamesh otiyot, that's still mitamei et hayadayim. Megillah shekatuv ba shmonim b'chamesh otiyot. Kiparshat Vayihi bin Soa Aron. If you have a Megillah scroll that has up to 80, that you've already written 85 letters, mitamei et hayadayim. It is mitamei et hayadayim, it's a Sefer Kodesh. Mishnah continues. Kol kitvei ha-kodesh mitamei et hayadayim. All holy books are mitamei et hayadayim. In addition, Shir HaShirim v'Kohelet mitamin et hayadayim. So obviously, there was a huge debate about Shir HaShirim, the Song of Songs, and Kohelet. These are books called Chachmat Shlomo. It's not entirely, Shir HaShirim Shlomo definitely wrote Kohelet. The big machloket about who wrote it. But obviously, where you see from the Mishnah, there was a huge debate about, are these two books, Shir HaShirim and Kohelet, in the biblical canon or not? Tanakhama says Shir HaShirim and Kohelet are in the canon. They are holy books. Now, Kohelet is like works of philosophy. Kohelet, they struggle with. Why? Because I wouldn't say philosophy about life. Much of Kohelet isn't really like, you know, your Jewish way of life. Basically, Kohelet's like, Havel Havali Mamar Kohelet. Everything is like not worth anything. Everything's a waste of time. So we all solve it by saying, in the end, he says, you know, Sof Devar Kol Nishma, in the end of Kohelet, Et Elokim Yira, you know, fear God. But a lot of people felt, at least in Chazal, that, you know, the one pasuk at the end of the book isn't going to save the whole book. Shir HaShirim is a love song. So Chazal answered Shir HaShirim by saying it's an allegory for the love between God and the Jewish people. But that doesn't mean you think that it was part of the biblical canon. So Tanakhama says, yes, it is. Rabbi Yehuda says, Shir HaShirim mitamei et hayadayim. Shir HaShirim is in. Mitamei hayadayim means it's a holy book. Kohelet mechloke. Rabbi Yossi says, Kohelet eino mitamei et hayadayim. Kohelet is out. It's not mitamei et hayadayim. Veshir HaShirim machloket. Shir HaShirim is a debate. Rabbi Shimon Omer, you get a huge debate about, huge machloket about whether these books are in or not. Kohelet mikulei Beit Shammai umichumrei Beit Hillel. Beit Shammai said out, Beit Hillel said in. Amar Rabbi Shimon ben Azai. Rabbi Shimon ben Azai said, mikubal ani mipi shivi mushnaim zakein. I have a Kabbalah. It's brought down to me in tradition from 72 elders. Bayom Shoshivet Rabbi Lezer ben Azariah by Yeshiva. There was that day. Remember that day that they sat Rabbi Lezer ben Azariah in Yeshiva. They made the Nasi. This is a very famous story in Masechet Brachot. One of the first things you learn when you learn Gemara Masechet Brachot. fourth chapter of Masechet Brachot, that they decided Rabbi Gamliel was too harsh, things weren't working out. They decided to appoint Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah, to become the Nasi. And there were a lot of stuff that Rabbi Gamliel didn't want to decide. He didn't make decisions about it. So Bo Bayom, on that day that they seated Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah, they decided a bunch of stuff. So on that day, Shashir Ashirim v'Kohelet Metamin Etayadayim, they decided, yes, Shashir Ashirim and Kohelet are Metamin Etayadayim. Amar Rabbi Akiva, said Rabbi Akiva, Chas v'Shalom. God forbid that there was ever even machloket. There was never any debate. Lo nechlak adam Yisrael al Shir Ashirim shelo titameh etayadayim. Lo nechlak adam Yisrael shelo titameh. No one ever argued, right, that it would not be Metamin Etayadayim. I don't know, Rabbi Akiva is like, he's thou dost protest too much. We've got a bunch of Tanaim here that did. Rabbi Akiva was like very vociferous about this idea. Chas v'shalom. She'en kol ha'olam kulo k'day. The whole world is not worthy. Kiyom she'nitan bo Shir Ashirim Yisrael. The day that Shir Ashirim was given to Israel. She'kol ha'ktubim kodesh. Rabbi Akiva says all of the written books are holy. V'shir Ashirim kodesh ha'kadashim. And Shir Ashirim is the holy of holies. Very famous statement. It's a love allegory between God and the Jewish people. It's a love allegory. It's the holiest of holy things. You can't handle the truth. V'im nechleku, and if they argued, lo nechleku al kohelet. They only argued not on Shir Ashirim, but on Kohelet. Rabbi Yochanan ben Yoshua ben Chamiv shel Rabbi Akiva. Rabbi Yochanan, the son of Yoshua, the son of the father of Rabbi Akiva, Kidibre ben Azai. Rabbi Ben Azai is right. Kach nechleku. Rabbi Akiva, yeah, he didn't like the fact they argued. They did argue, but they decided that Shir Ashirim and Kohelet are in the biblical canon. They are Metamei Etayadayim. They are Shirei Kodesh. We'll stop here. Dedicate our learning to my father, Simcha ben Yitzchak Kalma. Make it a great and holy day.